Even as they return to class, the students who lived through the school shooting in Parkland, Florida, are pushing gun control forward. And it's not just in Washington. This morning, Dick's Sporting Goods credited the students with a new gun sales policy. And in the past few minutes, Walmart made a similar announcement. But we wanted to know if these changes are brave or PR stunts. On the same day students returned to school in Parkland, Florida, Dick's Sporting Goods sent a tweet from its corporate account that sounded like so many others in the wake of mass shootings, offering thoughts and prayers to the victims and their families. But then it kept going, adding that thoughts and prayers weren't enough, and that beginning today, the company would no longer sell assault-style weapons, no longer sell high-capacity magazines, and no longer sell any guns to anyone under the age of 21.
We talked amongst ourselves and said, if these kids can be brave enough to do this, then we should be brave enough to make a stand ourselves.
But how brave is the Dick CEO and ownership really being?
I don't think it will have an enormous effect on their business negatively.
Alfred Marcus is a professor of strategy at the University of Minnesota's Carlson School of Business.
Is it a marketing ploy?
I don't think they could know beforehand with precision if it's going to help their market or hurt their market.
The company did already know its name was tied to the tragedy. The Parkland shooter purchased a shotgun from Dick's. Though it wasn't what he used in the attack, the company noted it as a factor in making these changes.
Is there history to show that taking a stand like this works?
You know, what do you mean by works? That's the question. I mean, if it influencing the debate, maybe marginally. Does it work in terms of hurting or helping the business? Not really clear. It changes the image of the business in comparison to its competitors.
But it's an image Dick's had already worked to change in the wake of the Sandy Hook school shooting in Newtown, Connecticut. At the time, Dick's announced it would ban assault-style weapons in its stores, but the company later allowed its 35 Field & Stream stores to continue selling them.
Why should we believe them this time?
I think they're learning their lesson, you know, that it has to be complete, that they can't make a compromise. It was a test, an experiment with their image. But I think now they feel that the management must feel very, very strongly about this to do it.
And they're not alone. Walmart, which stopped selling high-powered rifles in 2015, now announcing they'll also stop selling to anyone under 21. And Dick's CEO says he hopes it doesn't stop there.
This is a complex issue, and we hope that Congress on both sides will sit down with the intent of finding a solution.
Dick's even got into specifics, advocating for a long list of gun control measures. And like it or not, only time will tell if it makes a difference.
This has to be sustained. It can't be the issue of the moment.
Now, one major question, of course, that remains is another major gun retailer, is it going to follow suit? There's now a petition asking Bass Pro Shops, which also owns Cabela's, to make similar steps. So far, there's no indication either way. Jenna?
All right, thanks, Kent. Good stuff.